Okay, so I'm going to be doing some work on both of my cars this weekend. When I bought this truck, it had this little bit of touch-up paint right here. And I was okay with that, you know, just that little spot. It's a used truck. And then I came out this winter to look at it, and there was this big crack along here, and I ran my finger down it, and all the paint peeled off. So I'm going to take and I'm going to feather that, and then I'm going to paint it, and then I'm going to blend the clear using some rattle cans. And then on the Explorer, I'm starting to get these two little pieces of rust. So I'm going to grind that down, cut it out, weld it, and then I'm going to paint and re-clear this using this body line and this body line and kind of fade it up into here. And then I don't know if you can see that, but the back of this Explorer got bumped and it had a big peel mark over there, and then it had a big scratch over the fender and the top was peeling. So we sanded the top all down, fixed the scratch, and not a month later, Susan accidentally backed it into a brick wall. So I'm going to work on fixing this, the rust, and my hood. So on my hood, I've already kind of got started. I've got this piece of plastic off. So to get this off, you see these holes right here? The emblem, the Duramax emblem, sits right there. You got to pry that off, and then there's two screws, and then the rest of it just pops in. So I got that off. And now I'm going to take some 180 or 220, whatever I've got. I think I've got 80, 180, and 320. I might start with 320 and 320 this and see if I can feather this out. So let me put you on the tripod and then we'll get started on that. Thank you. Okay, let me show you what I've done. Down here, I thought that that was going to be holes, but it's not. It's just surface, just starting to bubble. So I'm going to put some filler in that to smooth it out, and then paint. We'll use this area here to blend. And then this side, I took the light out. It damaged it. So I'm going to fill this area here. And then we'll blend down to here and up into here, I hope. So, worst comes to worst, I'll have to take it over to my friend Troy. But I'm going to try it and see what happens. They're not Lamborghinis, you know. So anyway, let me show you this up here. So when I primed it, it wrinkled on me. So I had to resand it and then just put on light coats of primer until I got it covered. So now this is done. I'll wet sand that with some 600 and then we'll get it ready to paint. But I'm going to mix up some filler and put it in these holes. So let me see if I can get that done. I'll bring you back.
Thank you. Okay. There it is, all untaped. Still need to buff it. I don't know if you can see, but we got a little overspray. You can kind of see the line. That's just overspray. That'll, as soon as you hit that with the buffer, that'll be gone. I like it. Here's the Explorer. The little rust spots were right there, and they're gone. Got a pretty good blend, looks good. And then this was where it had been hit with the backed into the cement wall. And in this light, it looks really good. So they all need to be buffed still. But that'll probably be the last video I show of this. But there it is. I'm happy about it. It was a journey, but we made it. Okay, so here's the final results. I know you can't tell on the camera, but it turned out fabulous. The dents are gone. You can still see a little bit on the taillight lens. It actually broke the taillight lens, but I'll probably see if I can get a new one. But you can see the scratches, you know. I don't know if that helps. But that turned out great. My little rust repair over here blended really, really well. And last but not least, my truck. It turned out awesome. So what I had to do is, after I had painted it and cleared it, we had to wet sand it with 2000 grit and then buff it. And that is how you blend your clears. And I couldn't be happier. It turned out great. So there it is. On to another project.